We are joined by the away team head coach, Coach Pablo Fuengo. Welcome, sir. Coach, if you may just please give us a brief summary of the match from your perspective.
Once more, the same story in within a week. We played an amazing match. When we were playing 11 against 11, we hammered them. We created the chances, we hit the post. There was only one team in the pitch. From there, everybody saw what happened once more. And from there, with one man down, we were capable of containing them. We were capable of overcome the difficult situations and finish well the first half. Beginning of the second half again, we were dominating with one less man. We created the chances, we could convert, and in the end, after almost 300 minutes without conceding against Orlando Pirates any goal in any positional attack, they took advantage of one man down. I have to say that I saw lack of young gentlemen in that situation, because even against them they were not capable of beating us, and when Brooks was on the ground with 9 players, they took advantage to progress and to score the goal. But this is something that doesn't surprise me, because the other day in the cup, again, we kick a ball out because one of their players was on the ground. The ball was kicked when we were dominating the game in the half pitch, and they kicked the ball back to a throw for a goal kick, and they went to press. So these things that, from my side, when you are the underdog and the opponent needs to do these things or waste time or celebrate like if they were winning the World Cup when they have to beat us this way. The other day was with less numerical advantage, today even with more because we had one less player. And from there, you know, I only can feel proud of what my team is doing, competing against this kind of teams, the way we are playing, the way we are competing. The saddest thing of this story is that this is happening also against some other teams during the whole season, and it's having too much the club in terms of the results, and it's a pity that once more we have to talk about finishing a game with no points, with no reward, when we did everything to get even today 3 points.
We're now open for questions from the floor as per normal, by all hands. Please identify yourself as well as the media company you represent prior to asking your question. Do we have any questions?
Temba Shabala, Lechuza from Sports. Had luck on the result, Coach. From what you've just said, summing up the game, you are not happy about some things that happened in the match. Would you rather be specific about those incidents that you were not happy about, apart from Pirates there celebrating the victory? And why is it that you speak about the tactics that were used by Pirates? Why is it that you don't instruct your players to actually do likewise as well? So that if it works for Pirates, it might have as well worked for you.
First of all, for me it's unbelievable, and I think it's bad for the profession that you are the ones asking me to say what happened when you are the ones who need to be objective and to say what really happened. Because there's a play which is changing totally the game, and you all saw what happened. So if you want to listen from me, you're not going to get it. I think you tomorrow should write what happened, the same as you should have done the same last week, and you didn't talk about that, you didn't ask, or you didn't mention in any of the press conferences that we have had so far. And everybody saw and everybody knows. So I think it's very unfair. And I think you are not helping this football to grow up, because if we don't try to be objective and fair, then if we are totally blind because the power of a badge, then there's a huge problem, you know. When I'm receiving something and happened just once this season, I go to the press conference and I say we were lucky, we scored one goal and it was a handball, you know. This is part of the game. But here you are not interested in talking about this when the other teams are getting that advantage against Damasurgo, and I think it's pretty unfair. I'm sorry, but I have to tell you, I think then your job as a journalist is not complete. The other things, every team and every coach decides how to handle those kind of situations. We are all sometimes wasting time. This is part of football. We are all facing difficulties and we need to breathe from time to time. I'm not going to complain about that, and this is something that probably the opposition complained before about, but I understand. What I don't understand is that, for example, the last day China was 4 minutes and 15 seconds on the ground, and then when he's standing up in minute 89, the referees are giving just 5 minutes of in your time, and there were many substitutions, many interruptions apart from that one. Today the same, in the in your time they are coming to us to say that they are going to go for more time, and they are going for more time. So those are the things that the people who are managing the rules and the games need to control, and they are controlling the way they are doing, and you are seeing but you are not seeing.
Coach, we obviously we can see from the stands what's happening, but we're not as close to the action. We can't hear, don't really know everything that's happening. So for Mubara getting sent off, was it for the tackle or was it for descent? Did he say something to the referee?
No, he didn't say anything to the referee.
If it was for the tackle and you believe that it was the wrongfully red carded, do you think there should be an opportunity to be able to rescind the red card? Like, you go to the league and say this was a wrongfully sent off. I know it doesn't affect the game now, but to have him available in the next game, for example.
I think, again, if we want to make football a little bit more fair, of course, when there's a evident situation, then they should recognize the error publicly, because you know the funniest thing of these things is that the ones who are punished are the ones who are not doing anything, and the ones who are making mistakes are the ones who are going to be the next week making the same things. You know, so I think it's a great question, very clever, and I think if we want to be fair, we should have him available for the next games.
Good evening, Coach. Zarko from DNCNY. Considerations on the loss. Your frustration also just seems to have boiled over even to your players. We saw them even getting frustrated with the referees. How discouraging is it, and maybe how is it difficult now to get your players motivated for the next game when you have certain instances like this happening to you, like you believe maybe consecutively? And maybe just on Ethan Brooks, he came back today. He was a young man who came onto the scene with a lot of promise, also made the Bafana Bafana squad at some point. Do you think that you can actually get him back to that level?
I don't agree in most of the things you mentioned,
sure.
Even if I like the questions as well. But I didn't see frustration in the players affecting to their performance. Of course, now in the dressing room or in halftime, like last week, that's happened, you know, but the resilience of these players and the way they are overcoming these situations and these difficulties is huge, you know. This is something that is not the first, the second time it's happening this season. It happened many, many times. And we are facing many difficulties that you don't know. We face the loss of one of our players. I cannot see anything more difficult than that, not only in football but in life. And we are overcoming those situations, and we are or we keep going always, you know. Frustration, yes. It affects to the performance, no, because we saw the 2 days that we in the second half performed very well, and we put in a lot of trouble to the opposition, one of the best teams not only in PSL but in the whole continent without any doubt, full of great players, successful, you know. So from there, I think we cannot see frustration when you are performing after being harmed that badly. About the upcoming games, that's why I say most of the things. I'm worried because we are now in a position where it seems that we are not fighting for what we deserve to be fighting, and probably we are not going to fight for relegation. I don't think so. So what is going to be the motivation? We are also facing difficulties because we have players who are ending their contracts, and this is like in the rest of the teams, you know. And in this stage of the season, when you are so tired, when you are working so hard, when you are not in the place that you deserve to be, and you have all these things in your mind, it's going to be tough. I'm not going to lie, and I'm concerned and worried about that situation. And the last thing you said was, sorry?
On Ethan Brooks.
About Ethan. Yeah. Again, I disagree, because I think Ethan this season for us is one of our main players, and I think his performance has been amazing. You talk about him going with Bafana Bafana. This season he was in one of the pre-lists for the official games with Bafana Bafana as well. Last season in Amasulu he was, let's say, with a lot of respect for him, but a residual player. He even played many games with 3 different coaches. And this season from the beginning he's part of our first 11. He came back because he missed the last game for the suspension because of the yellow cards, you know. So I think he has grown a lot from the beginning of the season. He is there, he's reaching that level with ups and downs like all players all around the world, but I think he has something special and something difficult to find also here in South Africa for players. I think he's a guy who is really professional, who has consistency, and for me this is something that also seen the performances of the rest of the teams and the rest of the players during the whole season, it's difficult to find. So for me this is a plus, and therefore he's putting in all the games and in all the training sessions to be better and better is something amazing, and I would love that a player like him, I would love all the players because they are all working so hard, but especially one player like him, still young and with that spirit to improve every single day, would have the opportunity to play overseas or to play in Bafana. But I hope overseas or for big teams that happens when I live in the club. I want to keep enjoying him.
Final 2 questions. What? Not to reach the conclusion of our press conference.
Thank you.
Back shortly with the next coach. Thank you.
Have the same.